What do we know about a nasal spray developed by UCSF?
So the nasal spray actually has concentrated a formulation of what's called nanobodies, which are essentially like antibodies on a smaller scale. They're manufactured by genetically engineering yeast or bacteria to make them basically nanobody factories.
What does a nanobody do?
What they do is two functions. One is that they bind to the spike protein. That's the part that the virus uses to get inside human cells. And they basically kind of put a cover on it, so it's not able to interact with the receptor, the ACE2 receptor, to get into the human cells. And the second is they actually lock that spike protein into an inactive form.
How would it help in the fight against the coronavirus?
It could be a really useful, what we call plan B. So if you need a backup plan because you got exposed to the virus, this would be a really helpful way to try to prevent infection to those individuals that are exposed.
What do we know about a new Russian coronavirus vaccine?
Actually, we know very little about what's going on with the Russian coronavirus vaccine. And it almost feels like we had nothing and now something has dropped out of the sky. So personally, I have not seen any phase 1 or phase 2 data on this vaccine. And I've heard limited reports from the former commissioner of the FDA that it's been studied in 100 or fewer patients.
So what should we think about this new Russian vaccine?
At this point, I think this vaccine should be approached with a lot of skepticism and caution because it has not really been proven to be efficacious or safe, which are the two big milestones that every vaccine has to clear before we can start using it in the general population.